divorced and stay together for the sake of the children. A column in Rendezvous makes the point that children may benefit from their parents going their separate ways instead of staying in a miserable marriage. So, is a good divorce better than a bad marriage for kids? It's our daily dilemma. Please welcome media commentator John Caldwell to the panel to discuss this. Hey, John boy. Really interesting article. It actually sides with the divorce over staying together.
Yeah, it's a pretty loaded question because I think every situation is different. We have to remember that. But I would say that if the only reason that someone is staying in a marriage is for the children, then absolutely they should absolutely get out of there. We put it up on social media as well before and it's gone crazy, and I haven't had one person say stay. Everyone is saying get out of there. So there was another statistic that said 82% of the kids in a relationship that should divorce would rather the divorce as well. So
two sets of presents.
And that, kids can pick up on when there's animosity and angst in the home.
Absolutely. And I think the other thing is that sometimes when one of the parents is probably under a bit more pressure, they probably take it out on the kids without realising it as well. So they definitely would probably rather...
And was this written, it didn't say in the article, but was this written in response to Scott Morrison, I think, said that that he was concerned about the level of divorce and the impact that was having when he was addressing that the Christian group?
I don't think this particular article was that deep, but I think it's a good time to talk about it anyway, all the same. So,
my parents divorcing was the best thing that could have happened to our family because they were so desperately unhappy together. And I know that the relationship that I have with both of them is because they divorced.
Yeah.
And I look at both of them now and I can't imagine them ever being married.
Yeah.
And so I, you know, at the time, I think as a child, it can be very upsetting and traumatic, but... if they're not happy, they're not going to be the best parents they can be.
You can feel it as soon as you walk into the house, though, because there's a couple that I know who are not happy, but they're staying together for the children. They're doing exactly this. And you walk in and you can feel it. Even if they're having a good day, there's that kind of underlying tension that isn't good. The kids pick up on it all the time. They even say things to their parents and the parents don't want to really touch on it. But it's just awful. Get out of the marriage.
But maybe ultimately the kids want their parents to be happy.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, maybe they've got to, you know, kids sense that. And ultimately they just want their parents to be happy too, which is a great sentiment.
Is the problem, is it not the divorce we should be worried about, but the marriage in the first place? Are people rushing into marriage without necessarily thinking about how compatible they'd be when it comes to raising children, how many children they want, how they want them to...
Well, the point that this article makes is a very interesting one, that that marriage really hasn't changed much over the years except that no-fault divorces now exist. So, you know, 30, 40 years ago, it wasn't that marriage was made of stronger stuff, it's just that it's easier to get out of these days.
People are still miserable, they're just miserable together.
That's right.
The flip side, I want to point this out, because there's probably a lot of women at home feeling pressured now, saying, oh, God, but there's also some statistics... 1 in 5 women who divorce fall into poverty, 1 in 3 lose their family home, and 3 out of 4 don't get full child support. So there are factors here that we also need to think about. It's not as easy as packing your bag and walking out the door. So some really are protecting their children, but they have to think about those long-term ramifications, I think.
John Caldwell, always good to see you.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks.